गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस फोटोकेमिकल मशीनिंग प्रोसेस। व्हाट इज एग्जैक्टली द फोटोकेमिकल मशीनिंग प्रोसेस? दिस इज अ स्मॉल एडवांस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस। वी आर गोइंग टू कवर सिंगल प्रोसेस इन द लेक्चर। इट टेक्स ओनली 15 टू 20 मिनट्स। सो व्हाट इज द फोटोकेमिकल प्रोसेस एंड हाउ दिस प्रोसेस इज कैरिड आउट, ऑन विच मटेरियल it is possible to carry out, and what are the applications? We will discuss in details about this photochemical machining process. Am I audible to you, Amish? Please leave a message in chat box. Okay, thank you. Now in this photochemical machining process, now we will discuss about what is the basics of your photochemical machining process. If you are with me in your last session, last lecture about photolithography, then this session will be easier to you. Okay. Now, what is photochemical machining process? This photochemical machining process is also known as a photo etching process. Now, this photochemical machining process is the subtype, or it is similar to your photolithography process. I think all of you are having idea about what is the chemical machining process or chemical etching process, which you have studied in your manufacturing process to third year. Okay. So now today we will discuss about photochemical machining process, or another name is a photochemical etching process, which is the advanced part of your chemical machining process. Okay. Now this photochemical etching process is used to create a component in 2D also and 3D also. Okay. Now and where this process is useful, on which type of a material, what is the base material of your photochemical machining process? Most commonly used material in your photochemical machining process is stainless steel, copper alloys. This is the main materials. Plus, we can also implement this process on your aluminium, titanium and nickel super alloys. These are the base material which is useful to carry out the photo etching process. And what are the applications of your photochemical machining process? Applications, you can identify the application in case of automotive, aerospace, medical, defense, electronics, renewable energy and other applications. Means various components can be manufactured with the help of this photochemical machining process in these areas, like automobile, aerospace. And this process is highly flexible process as compared to the other processes, and allowing design changes to be implemented quickly and easily. Allow to change in your design means allow to change in your final product design while machining process. And its tool is also inexpensive. As we studied in case of a micro ultrasonic machining process, we need to manufacture the micro tool to carry out the ultrasonic machining process. But its cost and manufacturing process, its cost means manufacturing of micro ultrasonic machining process tool, it is expensive. Tool is itself, it is expensive, and manufacturing process is also expensive. But as compared to that process, this process is inexpensive. Okay. And this process is also possible to carry out the variety of a material, as we discuss in your second statement. Then this process is most commonly used in case of a fabrication of heat exchanger plates, and it is also possible to use in fluid flow channels can be created on a flat metal sheet using these techniques. Means fluid flow channels can be created by using in photochemical machining on a sheet metal. This is the introduction part of your photochemical machining process. As we discussed in last session, photolithography is divided into total 9 steps, and this process is also similar to your photolithography process. Few of the steps are similar of your photolithography process and photochemical machining process. So what are those steps? In this process, you have total 7 steps. First step metal preparation, second tool production, then third lamination, fourth printing and exposure, fifth development, sixth etching, seventh stripping. These are the seven main steps which we have to carry out to manufacture final finished product by using photo etching process. And also there is important point, note that point. What is the main point? This steps are independent of the type of a metal to be etched. Since it is independent to the type of a metal, which type of a material we can, it is possible to carry out variety of a material. So independent of a metal to be etched, the composition of the etching solution generally varies from metal to metal. Hence, we are using etching solution because this is your chemical process. So we are using etching solution to carry out the machining process because we are removing the material from particular portion to convert your raw material into the finished product. So it is, your process is depending on the different kind of a material, and for the different kind of a material we are using different etching solution to carry out the photo etching process, chemical process. Okay, in the next slide you can observe photochemical machining process, photochemical etching process. Now photochemical etching process for negative and positive working photoresist. Now in this process also we are using photoresist. As we discussed in previous lecture, we are having two different kinds of a photoresist, positive photoresist and negative photoresist. So first figure indicates your negative working photoresist, means we are using negative photoresist, and in your second process we are using positive working photoresist. You can identify the different steps, seven steps which is covered into these two processes. First circle represents your UV light. Again, your name implies photochemical etching process, means photo means we are using light source to create your raw material into the finished product by using chemical process. Okay, so we are using this input as a source, UV light source, which is incident over this tool. Now we have to prepare, second step is we have to prepare the tool. This is your tool, photochemical etching tool. Then photoresist is also applied, light source is incident over the surface, and this is your metal, which is also known as a substrate. Okay, when this tool is in come in contact and when the light is incident over your surface of the workpiece, then process will start, development of your material will take place, and etching means removing the material, it will create a shape as your tool is generated, means tool which is having the image, exact mirror image of your final finished product. So this is the process which represents stripping. Stripping means we have to remove the photo resist which is applied over the surface of your workpiece. This is the negative working process. You can identify, in case of your negative working process, this black portion which is come in contact with your photo resist, and here etching will starts. And another portion which represents there is no development or reaction will take place, and this portion remains constant unetched here. Okay, where we have to carry out the etching process, we will apply this region in case of your negative working photoresist. And exactly opposite case you can identify here, exactly opposite case you can identify, which is known as a positive working photoresist. Okay, now we will move to the next slide of your photochemical etching process. I think all of you have an idea about this positive and negative working process from the figure, because it is very simple process. Steps can identify how the process is going on. Okay. Now, first step, as we discussed in your previous slide, we have total seven steps to carry out the photochemical machining process. Your first step is a metal preparation, which is the most important step of your photochemical machining process. Why it is important? Because we have to prepare the surface of your workpiece, because we have to carry out, or we have to etch your surface. Etching is carried out on your surface. Okay, so raw material is prepared by using two steps. First of all, we have to cut your material into the required size and shape. After cutting, we have to cleaning. Cleaning is the most important part of your metal preparation, because if your surface is having some particles or dirt, then we have to remove this by using some chemical agent. So the cleaning process removes the grease, particulate matter and any other contaminants from the surface. Why it is important to remove? Because when we are applying lamination or mask or photoresist over the surface, then proper development, proper etching process, it should be carried out. For that, cleaning is important. Preparation of the surface is important. The cleaning step is critical, because any surface contaminants can lead to serious problems during lamination and etching. Okay. This is the serious problem. So we need to take care while cleaning of a metal surface. And after cleaning, okay, for this cleaning, what kind of a material we are using to cleaning this? Cleaning is achieved by using chemical agents. Degreasing and dilute acid or alkali solutions are used to clean your workpiece surface properly for the further process, as well as mechanically it is also possible to clean your machining surface with the help of the brushing the surface in automated machine. Means automated machines are useful to clean your surface properly for metal preparation. These are the two main steps of your metal preparation: cutting plus cleaning of a metal surface. Okay. Now we will move to the next slide, which represents your second step, tool production. This tool production plays important role, because tool production represents, because your ultraviolet light is incident over the tool, and tool which is having exactly mirror image or which is generated by the computer generated image, you have to create this image over the substrate or a workpiece. So it is important to create your tool with the help of the CAD drawing. We are using CAD drawing or CAD software to create a drawing. The pattern to be etched on a metal surface is produced as a digital drawing using CAD software and is then printed on a transparent polymeric film. Means after creating a drawing, it is printed over the transparent polymeric film to produce a photo tool. That is called as your photo tool. Printed over polymeric film, that is called as your photo tool. And this CAD drawing, it should be clear, it should be proper according to the dimensions. And that printing on a polymeric film and creating drawing with the help of the CAD drawing is also called as an undercut. But what exactly is that undercut? It is mentioned in the next point. What is the undercut? Its definition. Undercut can be defined as a lateral or horizontal etching. Lateral or horizontal etching means lateral or horizontal lines or the dimensions which is given over your polymeric film etching that takes place under the edge of a photoresist and is caused by the fact that the etching solution etches the metal surface in all the directions. Undercut represents your complete drawing where your etching process will carry out. Means etching means development will start, and in that portion only, in that area only, your material will be removed. That is your undercut portion. This is your second step to prepare the tool properly by using CAD drawing and printed over the polymeric film is known as an undercut. Now next step is your third step, lamination. What is lamination? A photoresist layer is applied. Lamination means we have to apply the photoresist. As we discussed in your previous section, we have two different kinds of a photoresist, positive and negative photoresist, because development will start with the help of this photoresist. Lamination. Now, what is the difference between your previous and this method? In this lamination process, we are using different kind of laminations, because it is applied over your surface, because this is your chemical etching process, photochemical etching process. The photoresist is a polymeric film containing binders. This is the main part. Polymers, acrylic, sorry, these are the main elements, photo initiators, which is applied over the surface of your substrate, which is known as a lamination, positive or negative kind of a photoresist. It is applied to protect, and main function of a lamination is it is applied to protect the surface of a metal from the action of a etching agent in the area that need to be etched. Okay. And main function, another main function is it is also gives you the good adhesion to the metal surface. After lamination, we will move to the next step because we have to carry out the printing of that particular CAD drawing over the workpiece surface. So the image from the photo tool is transferred to the superimposed on the laminated. Means CAD drawing is transferred to your lamination, and lamination to the your next step printing is carried out, sheet metal photoresist coated, that is called as a photoresist coated. These steps specify where etching process is carried out and where it should not carry out, allowed to develop or the etching process. Again, this is divided into two types as we discussed, positive and negative. I think it is already known to you. Still, I will explain. First represents positive photoresist. The photo tool specifies the area that need to be etched. Means when the photoresist is come in contact with your workpiece, then etching development will start and etching will start. That is called as a positive photoresist, described as a positive working photoresist. And second one is your negative. When the photoresist is come in contact with your workpiece, then in that portion only there will be a no development, no etching will starts. Okay, that is called as a negative working photoresist. Then this is called as your printing of your CAD drawing over the workpiece surface. Now next, after printing is done over the photoresist, this photoresist will expose to the, means we are applying chemical agent over the surface. After application of a chemical agent, then chemical reaction will start and also the UV light is incident over the surface of your workpiece. So it is exposed to, your surface is exposed to the UV light, ultraviolet radiation, from the ultraviolet light, and due to incident or that light, what will happen, the area of a photoresist that are protected from the radiation, then protected from the radiation by the opaque line on photo tool remains unaffected. Means the area which is protected, that will be unaffected, and the area which is not protected, that will be exposed to the radiation and it will start developing and etching will start, and that portion represents the creation of your CAD drawing, or exact etching will start at that position. This transfers the image from photo tool to the photoresist. When the light is incident over the workpiece surface, then the etching will start and it will indicate the image will start transferring from CAD drawing, that photoresist, to the workpiece surface, and you will get the required shape of your component. Then developing is also explained in your last session. Developing represents the development will starts when the UV light is incident over the surface. So the non-polymerized region of the photoresist are removed by exposing the lamination sheet to the mild alkaline solution. We are applying mild alkaline solution that is dissolved into the that particular region to start the development. Developments means reaction will start and it will remove the material in the form of a small granules or particles. Okay. So two different regions on the surface of a metal we can identify, which is exposed to the area where etching will start by developer is after application of a developer, then it will start etching. And second region where the developer is applied, but due to photoresist, this area is unaffected. Next, second last step represents etching. What is etching? I think all of you have idea about what is etching. Etching means creating that shape over the surface. The etching steps dissolves the exposed metal, which is exposed to the UV light, and the protected area of a surface under the photoresist remains largely unaffected. Means these are the two different areas, where first one, which is exposed to the UV light, which is etched, and second one, which is exposed to the UV light but it is protected by photoresist, remains unaffected. But how to carry out this etching process? This etching process is carried out over the workpiece surface with the help of the conveyor belt. Means we are clamping your workpiece, or we are placing your workpiece over the conveyor belt. After placing this workpiece over the conveyor belt, it will feed into the machine chamber. Means this workpiece is feed into the machine chamber to carry out the etching process. The sets of oscillating spray nozzles, means with the help of the spray nozzles, we are applying some solution to start the etching process. So conveyor belt motion will indicate the etching speed or time requirement. Reaction process time is also depending on the motion of your conveyor belt. If we are moving your conveyor belt slowly in your machining chamber, then it will take larger time. Machining time will be larger. Means etching process will take larger time to remove the material, and if the conveyor belt, if you are providing the speed to the conveyor belt is larger, in that case also the etching process will take faster rate. Okay. Then what is etching? Etching reaction means what is etching reaction? Oxidation of a metal will take place by etching agent, because we are spraying this etching agent over the workpiece surface with the help of the nozzles. There are lots of nozzles are available to spray the etching agent over the surface, and this metal will get exposed to this solution, and oxidization of a metal will start, and oxidized metal will dissolve into that solution, and depth of cut will achieve with the help of this, and chemical reaction will take place and material will be removed in the form of a small particle. This is the chemical etching process, chemical etching step. And lastly, after drawing, CAD drawing is completely transferred from first step to the sixth step, or finishing your product, we have to remove the extra material from your workpiece surface. We have to finish your final product by using your seventh step, which is known as a stripping, to remove the excess material from your workpiece surface. The photoresist is removed by exposing the sheet to a alkaline solution. Means we are using alkaline solution for stripping to remove the photoresist, because your process is complete now and we are removing the photoresist, and your final finished product is ready for the fabrication. This is done in stripping machine. Means we are using separate machine to removing the photoresist. Stripping solution is also mentioned here, alkaline solution. With the help of the spray also, we are spraying this alkaline solution over the sheet metal, and we will get the final finished product by using your photochemical machining process. The difference between your photochemical and simple chemical machining process: chemical machining means chemical reaction will take place due to application of some agents, and in this case also we are using simple ultraviolet light to carry out the reaction plus chemical agents. Okay, this is your machining process. Next machining process, photochemical machining process. I hope you understood this process, what is exactly the photochemical machining process, difference between photochemical and photo etching, photochemical and chemical machining process. If you have any doubt, please leave a message in chat box.